eSportBets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. eSportBets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
We have returned once again. Here we go. It is the final match of the evening between NaVi and Team LDLC.com. So a big welcome to all of you to Room on Fire. Of course, I'm here. I've got Samler and Vendetta with me as always, and it's going to be great fun. I think this match could actually be a hell of a lot of fun. Remember to follow the channel, and also if you really want to help us out, subscribe to it. And a big thanks to everyone who already has. We're almost at 2,000 subscribers, and we're really, really pleased about that because it gives us such a lot of room to try and keep the channel alive and make it active all the time. That's what we want to do, of course, and yeah, so a big thanks to all of you for doing that. There's a Facebook link at the bottom of the page where you can participate in the raffle, and you can go and check that out as well, and you can win all sorts of cool stuff. So do that as well. We need as many people doing it as well. That helps out our sponsors, so that's a big help as well. Now, here we come. I mean, you guys have to make a prediction. We've been seeing all sorts of people dropping crazy scorelines, 30, 40 kills. So tell me who in this match from each team is going to be the top fragger, Samler and Vendetta.
For NaVi... I feel it's kind of easy, kind of a cop-out to go with Guardian. am I allowed to go with Guardian? Out? Well, he just dropped nearly 40 in his previous game.
Well then, it's clear. It's clear where you need to be going, man. It's the Guardian points. Anders has got his pom-poms out. He's had them out all night long, but you can just barely hear, you know, in the background, you know, him going, Guardian, yeah, Guardian. But all night long, if Guardian drops a 40 bomb, Anders is going to lose it completely.
I just might.
I think it gets harder when we go to LDLC. Like,
For some reason, I feel there's more people to choose from on LDLC.
Right?
I could see Kaylee doing it. I could see Apex doing it. Who knows? Maybe Happy has the game of his life. It could happen. And I just don't know. It's hard. I think if I have to choose, I'm going to go with Apex.
Alrighty. Okay.
That would not be my choice on LDLC side.
Really? Who would you go with, Anders?
I'm gonna go with Uzi.
Uzi for a 30 bomb?
Uzi.
Well, yeah, for top fragging on I feel like Apex has been, I don't know, some matches actually recently he's been stepping in a lot, but if you go back like 2 weeks or something, I feel like Apex has been a little bit more sleepy than ever. He's not been playing badly, don't want to say that, but just maybe a little bit more sleepy than the level that I actually expect from him. So that's just because I think Apex is a really good player, so it's nothing, you know, it's nothing like that. I just have higher expectations. Now, here we go. NaVi LDLC, best of one on SLTV Starseries. Welcome to the show. Invite your friends, and let's have some fun with the final match of the evening here.
Oh, yeah, quick question, Sam. Who's your pick?
Who's going to drop the 30 frag? It's going to be... I'm going to use the cop-out Guardian on NaVi.
And LDLC.
LDLC, Kaylee.
Alright.
Okay. Well, oh, Zeus and Guardian, absolutely magnificent start. And Starix just turning around. I've never seen a slaughter quite like that. The term meat grinder comes into place, but I'm not even sure it's brutal enough. That was just... That was devastating. It's like they were... I don't know. That was terrible. Well, what did you just see?
There's not much to be said.
That's basically NaVi landing all the shots and LDLC kind of running into the blender. I mean, it was the full YOLO, no fear. We're going to do it, guys. We got this. And then they just all take bullets to the face because Guardian and Starix played so well.
Yeah, completely wrecked in that A-bomb site. And Zeus does go down in the middle. LDLC have gone for armor and C-set 75s, and they're making some work happen here. Actually, they've turned into a 2-on-2 grenade up the middle and will finish off Uzi. But again, NaVi struggling in these anti-eco rounds, and this time, I actually think it was more than just a little bit their own fault. They were just being oversellers in that middle and just re-peaking again and again and again instead of playing it safely, which is what they've been doing all day.
It really is, and right now it's all down to Happy here to make something happen. And he might be able to pick up Seized as well here, because he does have armor and a Colt, so NaVi should not count this round as one already.
No, but the crossfire that they have going here, Guardian is at the top of mid, Seized is waiting on short, so Seized can spot basically can spot Happy coming from upper right now as we see. You know, he's working his way into the window, turns away, still lands a shot on Seized, but this is still all information for Guardian. And with 30 seconds left on this clock, it's not going to get any easier here for Happy. He needs to find a kill fast to break this crossfire he's about to walk into.
And jumps down, still wants to pick up that bomb, but Guardian will finish him. And by no means an easy or a safe round coming in here from NaVi. Actually a terrifying round, to be quite honest.
That really was. I'm nearly losing four members because Seize got down to 16 HP at the end there. That could have easily gone wrong. And I'm not really sure why Seize was peeking so heavily as well. The at best Happy could jump out from CPL window into mid and do something from there, but that they would have heard that. He couldn't jump into Whorehouse without Seized hearing it as well, so I'm surprised at the fact that he actually took that challenge so often.
Alright, Seized with a good pick off here, and also in the middle was Sousa taking a quick kill in this round. Very different from the last one, of course. LDLC didn't really have any armor, and they will take off the one kill there. Happy has actually renamed or redubbed himself the Messiah, which I guess could be fitting later on. He's a really good player, but whether or not he's going to be able to actually salvage the game from LDLC, we'll have to find out. It's the fourth round coming up, and they are purchasing rifles, including that AWP on Kaylee.
Oh, yes. Hi. Kaylee played sick at Aces ROG over the weekend, so let's see if he can actually pull off anything here online on this best of one match versus NaVi versus Guardian. Seized, just throw the nade, man. Oh, he's going to take the peek instead. And that'll give it away. LDLC should be able to back off, take minimal damage. But of course, Seized, you know, he can't see through walls. He doesn't know like we do.
Hopefully,
and unfortunately, that's how it goes.
Put it like this. If Seized has been able to see through walls all day, he's been playing much worse than I thought.
Yeah.
Well, maybe it's like matchmaking, you know? It's like they can see through walls, but they're still not good enough to land the shots.
Those are some funny Overwatch demos. I love those. Well, Edward's up here on short waiting and could maybe catch a kill on somebody. He's got to be careful. The timing is everything, and he's going to walk right into Kaylee. He spots the barrel. He's going to walk up, and oh, Apex saves it. What a massive frag, and now they're going to go for the B-bomb sign, and they should as well. Rotation is happening from Seuss here. I think Edward just got robbed of a great double kill.
Yeah, look at Happy, though. Happy can cause a lot of trouble if LDLC buys him enough time. Actually, he's backing away now, so that point is completely mute. Now I think it's actually a favorable position for NaVi to be in.
Uzi walks up with his back turn, still picks up the kill, and Seized is going to get the one kill in it, but this is now a 2-on-3 and a completely confusing round for coming out from NaVi here. I have no idea how Uzi picked up that kill. Guardian is going to be walking in here, takes down Apex with an incredible flick, and because Happy's really far away, if they move quick, he is going to be here on time now, as they've delayed a little bit, but 2-on-2 now rushing in towards the bomb site. Flashbang working really well against NaVi or Guardian here, but it's going to be a 1-on-1. Starix peeks the corner, and Happy goes down, and the defuse is going to be real, so that's unfortunate. Looked like LDLC could have had that, and looked like NaVi should have had it much earlier. I don't know. If this is following true of the trend of this whole evening. This whole evening has been nothing of except for us saying, you know, it should be one team, but it's the other team.
Yeah. In a lot of ways, that's what we've been witnessing. I think LDLC got a tiny bit lucky of actually catching the NaVi player on the bomb site off guard as they pushed through. I think it was Edward who got one frag on Uzi on short, but if he had his focus towards that B bomb site, I think NaVi would have been able to shut down the entire push quite easily.
I'd love to see... nice jump from Guardian, just spots a couple of people down there. I'd love to see LDLC go for a standard A push really soon. Just, you know, the smokes, the flashes, take the bomb site, see if they can defend it. Because it's worth doing, I think, early in the game, just to see if it works. If it works, you can keep doing it. If it doesn't, then you sort of ruled it out and you can go something different. Seuss is going to be walking in here in the middle, does hear a couple of people. And Uzi's throwing some good grenades in here, and Seuss is still going to pick up the kill. But they have the one man boosted up here, and that's Happy, and this could be really big.
Happy's position right now is crucial, especially since Zeus picks up two frags. Starix is waiting right around the corner from T-Pit as well, and this is still the smoke timings. As soon as that smoke clears, Starix needs to get something done, and he's not going to do it because, hey, guess what? Happy gets two.
Yeah. Guardian missing a shot, and he's trapped behind that box. Apex running and gunning will finally drop him down, so there's a great round coming in here, and Happy's position paying off really massively. Which is a little bit strange, because actually he was being spotted already. Finally goes down after that triple kill, and now it's gotta be joking me. Seized turns it from a 1-on-3 into a 1-on-9. He's going to flash himself in here. Maniac doesn't get caught with the flash, but I think he knows where he is. He's going to peek out, and he does get the kill. Maniac saves LDLC and finally brings up Brown on the board here and actually forces Na'Vi into a position where they have to eco.
And that was a more or less great decision-making and great shooting from Happy that made that possible for LDLC. He got as much as you could possibly hope from that position, because as you said, I think Sue spotted him out at a certain point there, because he was aiming towards the jungle for a large part of that situation.
And Na'Vi's just been spotted going down underpass, so they're weirdly trapped in here, and they've bought all sorts of rifles. I have no idea why they decided to buy up in this round. I could sort of understand it if they could go for Mars. This is a shotgun and a deagle, and a shotgun works! What is Maniac doing? He knew for a fact that there was someone down there with a shotgun, or at least he knew there was someone down there. That is not a smart choice.
Alright, now it's down to Kaylee. Seized is here. Seized is ready to peek out with his mates as well, and he's gonna get the opportunity. Kaylee gets caught, and this is just shaping up to be a fantastic round for Na'Vi. The buy works wonders. It's gonna be Happy Alive. The M threw me off. But it's going to be Happy Alive 1v4, and Na'Vi should be able to lock this down. But that buy was all about just shutting down LDLC's money. If LDLC lose this round, they're on hard eco for a long time.
I need more than just my own two hands to facepalm enough to what just happened this round for LDLC. I definitely appreciate what you're saying, because you're absolutely right. This buy is definitely about LDLC's money, and now they are really screwed. And I think Na'Vi's choice of jumping down on underpass was even a really good one, but they were spotted. The people on the top of mid spotted them from LDLC, which means Maniac had no business basically peeking. At least if they wanted to peek, they could have walked in from both sides. I cannot really explain that. So definitely, I think that was a mistake basically on Happy's side. Oh, sorry, on Maniac's side, unfortunately.
The way that it's shaped up, Maniac, I mean, I think it's just like confidence at that point, you're right, but it, you know, it's confidence that lets him think that he can take that fight. Edward is going to get picked off by Kaylee though, so that's not too bad, but Seized is here to pick it up on short, and he will find Kaylee, who's waiting on Delpan. So back into a into a 4-on-4. Uzi standing his ground at mid, he's going to get chased away. And Na'Vi are focusing on mid once again. They're really wanting to deny LDLC any kind of movement here. They're just really getting in their faces with Starks watching their back on the A site.
Look at Maniac coming up all the way from the death hole here. Sneaking up in the B bomb site. This is a great flank, but he only has a pistol. He's going to take down Seuss. And that gives up the game, but it's turned into a 2-on-3. And Maniac, he's running away, giggling to himself probably because he got that kill. And I don't blame him. That was really, really a nice flank. Goes for a second one here on Seized, and pistol versus rifle is not really a fair fight as Apex is actually going up the underpass, so Maniac is just doing great work buying time for him, but it might not be enough here as Apex gets the kill, which is still impressive, but he's in a 1-on-2 with 25 seconds and just 11 HP.
Exactly, and they've already rotated around to cover this A side as well. Seized just watching towards the mid, keeping an eye on short to make sure that Apex has no easy route in. Apex is just currently looking towards short, but he has to turn around and run. 15 seconds left, Starks is already waiting, and as soon as he walks past into the open, Apex is gone. So 6 rounds now for Na'Vi. Expensive rounds. I mean, these are really shaping up to be entertaining rounds. Even on an anti-eco, Na'Vi are losing a lot of people. But at the end of the day right now, Na'Vi are still ahead, and they've got the round lead.
Vendetta, I have to ask, what do you make of all these games that we're seeing, or at least the 2 games tonight that we've seen, where people actually pick Mirage against Na'Vi? Do you think this is a way of sort of saying before the big tournament we're going to try and challenge them and you know, test if they're still the best?
Maybe they're hoping that Na'Vi will show some of their hand, I guess, before Gamescom. Though I don't think that's very likely. But then again, Na'Vi aren't playing too out of the ordinary compared to what we've seen earlier. I'm not really quite sure because, Sue's actually jump-shotting Kaylee there. But yeah, they've been playing fairly standard for what Na'Vi have been doing previously, and I'm surprised that teams actually want to play up against a team like Na'Vi on this map.
I am too, definitely I'm surprised. I mean, Hellraiser's managed to tie the game, or actually was almost like Na'Vi managed to tie the game the other way, because Hellraiser's were winning for a majority of that game, but now this eco round doesn't work out all too well, and Na'Vi now are at a 7-1 scoreline with Seized being the top fragger. Did anyone guess Seized? Because I had Guardian down as well, and he's on the bottom, so I'm just let down here by Ladislav.
I think all of us counted on Guardian to come up big. I didn't really consider Seized simply because he's been not the same Seized we've seen as of late earlier today, but would be great for, obviously it's a great thing for Na'Vi if he turns it on right now.
Starix walking in here, and Apex goes down. Really good timing, and Apex was also semi-flashed at that point. That smoke was supposed to actually be down towards the ramp, but Zeus managed to body block it, which was obviously not intentional. But the push is going to be for the A bomb site, and this is the standard A push that I wanted them to do, but it's not working out so well. Not like I imagined that right now. They're going to be finally a kill in here, but Edward's still on the site, and Kaylee's very nearly dead. In fact, now he is definitely dead, and Happy alone once again trying to clutch it here. One on two. And they are both at the site, and Guardian will step it up and hit the shot here. And it's going to be 8-1, no bomb plant, and they might as well just force it up, I think, at this point.
Yeah, things are already getting out of control. They've lost four rounds in a row. They are probably going to be in a situation where they have to buy up each and every round as long as they keep losing, because this situation is getting more and more out of control. And even there, not just having luck on your side, with Apex getting picked off by Zeus so early on in the round before you're about to execute one of your set strats.
Oh, Guardian looking for the shot on somebody, but they're coming up underpass as well, and that's a great headshot from Kaylee. Long range with the AK, and he just connects the bullets, so that's what they needed. Take out Guardian, you know you're doing a fine job early on if that happens.
Now, if you can pick out Guardian, that's actually a lot of room to breathe. Apex has got his AWP as well now. So Apex with a bit of an opportunity to get something done. He can probably pick out Starix or Zeus, who's about to peek. And great flick. There we go. That's what we're expecting from Apex. A good flick, a good kill, and LDLC in a perfect position to pick up two frags, or two rounds, rather.
Oh, Edward, yeah, jumping out the window. Going to pick up the one kill. Could be a double. He runs out of bullets. Going to re-peek against Usian. That's the bomb drop. Then it's a 2-on-3. Now 1-on-3. Oh, no! LDLC! They had it going on, but Edward, he stole their groove right then and there. Kaylee comes in, and he's angry as hell, and I don't blame him for it, but Edward is close. All he has to do is wait. Kaylee has to come, and now he's even going to swap over to the other side, making it even harder for Kaylee to guess where he's going to be. This is really smart movement from Edward. I'm loving this.
They're going to force him in the open as well. Look at Edward. It doesn't get any better than that. That teamwork at the end between Starks and Edward, so sick. Edward sneaks into Whorehouse, and then they block off the exit, not allowing the LDLC member to escape.
My god, that was... That's one of those really soul-destroying rounds, I think, from LDLC, where they feel it just like we did. They had the opening. Apex was doing so well that round, and then it just gets stolen away from one guy. And I have to really credit Edward with the movement he had this round. Jumping out a window was ballsy, but it worked, and then sneaking up into Whorehouse afterwards was just brilliant, so... That's just very smart play coming out. Guardian double shot in the middle, and that is not too often we see that, but it's a rare and a very delightful sight when it happens. C is going to be jumping up here and takes down Maniac, and it's going to be a swift round. It's already done as Happy goes down to Zeus. 10-1, utter destruction, rain down upon LDLC in that middle area.
That was a treat for the viewers.
Yeah, exactly. The big plays are coming out now. Guardian, I mean, he's trying to get back on top here, and he's actually not that far behind. Four more kills, and he's going to be catching up with C's. We'll see. There he goes. Actually, that's Edward going down. Guardian swapped all the way over towards the catwalk.
Is Guardian going to be able to hold, though? They're going to put some pressure on him, and he already has to fall back quickly. Apex around the corner. Guardian misses the shot, though. And Kaylee's going to pick off his teammate Zeus. So this is, that's the A site vulnerable now in LDLC. They seem to know it. They're already moving through Connector. They're moving through Whorehouse. And they are up in window. Apex at the murder hole. Picks off Seized. And this falls apart now for Na'Vi.
Yeah, so I don't know. It seemed like with that first kill on Edward, it just set the whole Na'Vi team in motion. They just... And every time they rotated somewhere, they got another, you know, guy, they lost another guy on their team, and then they just kept going that way, so nobody ever actually ended up standing still and covering anything. It's a strange round.
Nice work from LDLC, though. Managing to get control over mid pretty quickly. Might have been due to the fact that Edward was in mid instead of Guardian, obviously, but once they got down Edward in mid there, they just instantly smoked off short and ran with it, and Kaylee picking up a second frag at that point. So, well, more or less gives them the bomb site.
Oh, well, this is going to be the second round in the first half for LDLC. Even if they get five, I don't think it's going to be enough. I think they need it to get more than five. I think 9-6 was a minimum, and preferably something like 8-7 would have been even better, quite obviously. So Na'Vi still have money. Even if they lose the upcoming round, they might still be able to force it up because they have a bank on Guardian and Seized here. So we're going to have to see, and they've picked up an auto-sniper assembler.
Yeah, man. And it's on Edward as well. How often do we get to see him go to Star 20? That's a rare sight. I can't remember recent memory the last time I saw Edward go for a Scar 20. That's really cool. Oh, but, I mean, now he needs to actually make it work. He's looking towards mid, but nobody's here from LDLC. So, Edward, are you going to get your time to shine? Seized is just holding B apartments with the rifle only. I would have expected Edward to actually rotate over to cover B apps with that scoped rifle.
I agree. I think that's the better position for it. That grenade is really good, though. Kaylee down to 56, and Seuss will pick him off easily there. So now a really bad start, and we said 10-5, but the fact is, if LDLC lose this round, we could be seeing a very different scoreline altogether.
This is a big opportunity, you're right. Money is kind of scarce on Navi's side, but LDLC at this point, they've got kind of like a double pincer movement onto A site, one through or two through connector until Edward manages to catch Apex off guard.
The timing there from Edward was just unreal. The second Apex turned away from Catwalk, actually, he pushes up.
Oh, but he misses those shots. Now it's going to be down to the guy on ramp here. Starix has to come up pretty big. Seast is coming in. I think if Starix just waits and stays alive, maybe they can somehow manage to sandwich them in here in the bombsite. No bomb plant happening yet. In fact, 20 seconds left. And do they even realize he's out here? If he gets the kill on Uzi right now, he's not going to walking around there. And he makes some noise as well. So now Happy's alerted to the situation. A big misplay from Starix and actually an unnecessary mistake there.
An unforced error?
Yeah.
That's Seized now alone. 1v3. There's good damage dealt to Happy, but Happy's in a pretty good spot right now in Shadow. And he's going to be able to react in time. Go for Seized, drops him by half health, and that's all he needs to do, really, because the remaining members there, too. Uzi will pick up the frag, but Happy gets caught, but that's all that needed to happen there to secure the round. And LDLC, I mean, do you think, Ben, that five rounds is enough for LDLC for them to consider this a solid first half?
Solid, no. Something they can live with, yes. But Navi are... Navi are a pretty good T-sided team as well. Obviously, I think their stronger side is their CT side, but I don't feel worried for Navi going into the second half. I do, however, feel quite worried for LDLC.
Happy gets picked off here, and I'm definitely worried for LDLC as well. Pushing up here. Oh, Maniac catches Seuss jumping over, not taking the designated route down the stairwell, so that works out just fine for him. Sometimes not living by the rules is just more worth it. And now
he was reliving his younger years, right?
Exactly. If only he had a skateboard, maybe he could have, you know, just, you know, slid down and made some sort of cool movie out of it. And Starix again finds himself in actually a very good position if it's going to be an A push, and if it's a B push, Guardian and C-Star here. So this round isn't over yet, but LDLC do have the man advantage.
Seized is in a pretty good spot, though, if they manage to come through. There's the flash, turns around, goes for the spray, and gets two! I don't even know.
Oh, wow. Guardian jumping, oh, sorry, running and shooting. Now it's going to be the one-on-one. Starix is quite far away. Maniac runs to pick up the bomb, and he's actually going to be greeting Starix here. This is a really brave play coming out. Starix doesn't realize he picks out the gun, and oh, no! He gets the headshot. Maniac looked like he had the timing. Looked like Starix was unaware what was going on, but he realized in the very last second, and that will put us at 11-3 here, moving into the last round of the first half, and LDLC, at least they can still buy, but... You know, they needed this round too.
That's heartbreaking though. They actually managed to flash out Seize, then he gets the two players that he had no idea was coming around that corner. That's just really unfortunate if you're the French team.
That's heartbreaking.
And look at the Seuss, same thing happening again, and this time at least he gets to look before Maniac comes in, and Maniac goes down this time. But the A-bomb site is significantly weakened. Edward running up close is going to take down Uzi and drops to Kaylee. What a crazy battle here in the middle. And wondering if LDLC... I don't think LDLC even realized that everyone on A is dead.
Well, they have no idea. But they should know at this point because both Navi members have encountered LDLC players. So at this point, they should know. But actually, with the time they're taking to actually commit to this A-bomb site, Seas can get into a pretty good position.
Yeah, he can. Picks off one. Now it's a one-on-two here. Seuss versus Happy and Kaylee, and now just versus Kaylee, who does have that AWP, and he has a grenade as well, which could kill Seuss, but he's going to reposition himself, and I'm just waiting for it. Is he going to get the right timing? Kaylee, one grenade is all it takes. Happy, oh sorry, Seuss walks in, picks up a smoke. Grenade doesn't connect, and now this smoke could really help out, because Kaylee has the AWP. So we're about to see. He walks up. Kaylee spots up. He misses the shot. There's no time for that one. And now doing damage. One more click here is going to be enough for Susan. He's ready and waiting patiently. Almost sprays him down. Pistols out. Kaylee can't hit any shots right now. He's on 2 HP and he's going to go down. And there's enough time for the defuse. You've got to be joking. Oh my god. One click would have been enough here and Seuss would have been dead. LDLC, today is not their day.
It really isn't. And no, I'm surprised nobody is actually... Well, surely whoever encountered Seuss earlier on in the round has informed that. I think it was Maniac, right? When Seuss pushed up overpass or underpass. Surely he must be aware that you've put quite a dent in his armor. So I'm surprised that we didn't see Kaylee pull out the pistol after missing that first op shot and just going for the best.
Yeah, that was just a very strange battle at the end. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that puts the first half score at exactly 12-3 in favor of NaVi. It's a best of one game, so now it's on LDLC to win the pistol round and bring it back. If you're just joining us, then a big welcome and thanks for joining us here at Room on Fire. Hope you guys will follow and subscribe to the channel. Our mark, our goal here is to hit 200,000 followers, and we're at 170,000, so 30,000 more and we'll get there, and it's going to be a huge day when we do that. Definitely going to be giving some stuff away. Big thanks to all the subscribers. We do appreciate it. You guys are helping us so much with keeping the channel as active as it can be, so we do love that. So Facebook link at the bottom of the page, and just as we're paused here anyway, waiting for one guy to reconnect in, you can go and visit that and give it a like. That's for our Facebook raffle, courtesy of Case King, who are our sponsors for our weekly tournament. So definitely do that. This week you can win a Team Group solid state drive, which is a 240 gigabyte SSD drive. Really nice one, and will speed up your computer a fair bit. So if you want to win that, you can go and check it out. And you can also win the 10 upcoming weeks just from the one click. So you only have to click once and you're going to be good to go. So that's pretty much it. I think I almost covered everything. But yeah, we're getting really late, at least Central Europe here. We're getting to about 11 o'clock in the evening. And we still have 40,000 people tuning in. So I love the fact that you guys are showing us the kind of support. It really means a lot to us here at the channel.
Absolutely. There's no getting around it. But this is a good match. And it still has potential. I mean, LDLC, favorite side, if they can actually lock down this pistol round, they have been landing shots. They just need to do it consistently now in this round. I think you cursed Uzi, though, Anders, because he's 6-2-13 right now.
I'm so sorry, Uzi. I really am, because I have faith in you. And I really do think Uzi's just been stepping it up so much. I'm sorry to have done that. Didn't really mean to, but yeah, I wanted to go with the odd man out. And we have seen Uzi top frag in the past, so it wasn't even maybe that odd of a choice, but I thought I was being clever, and obviously I ended up ruining it. So sorry.
Well, all of our picks are underperforming, yeah. I guess.
Yeah, the curse is real.
The curse is real.
This might be the first map tonight where there isn't a 30 bomb dropped.
That's a good
point. Well, the night is still young, I guess. Well, the night isn't, but the game is... It still has the potential. If LDLC gets off to a good start, who knows?
Yeah, they could bring it back. Maybe Happy's going to pick up another 18 kills here and just go crazy, but they're rushing. Actually, the bomb is still all the way back here, so this is a really weird rush from NaVi. If they take the bomb site, they're going to have to wait for the bomb to show up, and Maniac here actually still alive. Apex goes down, and this is working out really great for LDLC. It's just Guardian and C's left, and I'm not sure I agree with rushing a bomb site and then having the bomb be a good, I don't know, 10 seconds behind.
That part, I don't agree with either, but I do like the fact that NaVi did something. It seems like they expected LDLC to know what their regular pistol round is, which is the A-tick with smokes, and they did kind of, in a sense, execute it. They threw down the smokes and whatnot, but instead they had Guardian, but Susan Starks, I think, running up short, which I actually completely agree with. I think it's a nice twist to throw in there. Like, just show that you have the potential to fake and that you're not completely locked into one idea.
Oh, Maniac coming up absolutely massively there. That was great. That's a quad kill, and last two were really impressive. But maybe you are right, Vendetta. Maybe there was some potential there. Now it's 12-4, and LDLC at least winning one round that they had to win.
Oh, they're one step closer. That's how they have to look at it, because they can't do anything else but take it one round at a time in this situation. And now, the dreaded anti-eco is coming up, so they need to minimize their losses this round, not aggressively overpeak and all that good stuff. And they should be in for a good start.
What are we going to see here? Already? Well, we're just going to see a slaughter, pretty much. Nothing really fancy here, guys. Move along. This is just LDLC mopping up, pretty much.
The show is over. There's nothing else to see. You're right. Starix still wants to waste a little bit of time hoping to pick someone for the Glock. Which is not going to happen. Happy says, no thank you. That's 12-5, moving into the 18th round, and Navi are going to buy, in spite of the fact that they didn't put the bomb down yet, did they? No, they didn't.
They didn't. They've been shut down pretty hard in both rounds so far of the second half. So this buy is... something that might catch LDLC off guard, actually. I don't think they're going to expect this, seeing how Navi didn't get that plant in the pistol round.
Grenade, the middle. A little bit of softening up on Guardian. Now they're looking, waiting for Kaylee to re-peek, but he's going to be playing it carefully.
I want to see where they go with this. Are they going to try for a boost into window? No, they're trying to look towards that A site. An instant headshot onto Messiah. So nicely done there by Seized.
It's got to be really annoying, right? Waiting down there. They do have the bomb over by the A slope, and now they're finally going to commit to it here as Kaylee takes down Guardian in the middle. So a really nice opening coming out here. Seuss is going to be walking out of the apartments, but there's someone waiting for him right down there. I actually think Seuss is not in a great position, but he picks up the one kill. And can he get another one? Apex now looking, and Seuss is going to go down. It's a 3-on-4. The bomb making its way up, and Apex coming up with some really valuable kills here as Kaylee takes down Edward as well, and this round sort of falls apart for NaVi. 1-on-4. I think there was some potential this round, but I don't know. LDLC just rotating nicely and getting pick off some great angles.
Yeah, NaVi didn't really get into anything at all. They managed to smoke off short and CPL, but anything else than that? They didn't get the pickoffs they were looking for. Seize nearly managed to take out Happy, but it never really got scary for LDLC at all. It seemed like they had pretty good control over what was going on, even though they lost, gave up control over mid.
Charging in, running and gunning here, and Kaylee just barely survives. That was an insane play coming up from NaVi, but they didn't really get anything for it, and Kaylee should be able to stay alive. Edward goes down, and inside this A-bomb site, it's Seuss to fall next. As he does go down, Guardian is going to be alone in a 1-on-5 with 2 HP and gets dropped by Maniac, so a good cleanup round coming up from LDLC. Now we're at a 12-7 scoreline. I mean, this is still a 5-round difference, but it's not out of the question that LDLC can make it back right now. As ridiculous as it sounds, they only won 3 rounds in the first half. It is doable.
Yeah, that's the thing. They've already brought it back to 7 rounds for them, and they've still got a lot of money in the bank. So that's another big thing here. Even if they lose members, they're going to be able to re-equip their team to be a consistent threat here throughout the rest of this half, at least for quite a while. Not throughout the rest, but quite a while. NaVi are going to have to deal with them. And just double push in A apartments, picks up 2 kills, and Messiah is still able to hold from Electric. That's going to open everything up here for LDLC. They're going to just shut NaVi down. There's only 3 members left, and Starix has to find a kill, and he does.
Yeah, but this is a really nice setup from LDLC. I'm absolutely loving it. And right now, NaVi are actually in a box, and it's really hard for them to get out, I think. Bomb is going to go down. Apex almost gets a shot through the smoke. That was incredible. Nice angle. And Molotov comes out as well. Starix trapped in a weird corner. All he has to do is wait. I don't think he has to challenge. He's going to have to rely on his teammates. And there it comes. Guardian and Seized. And now Guardian with one more shot. He can do this. And he's going to go down to Happy. So there it is. LDLC do win the round. But really only barely. I thought that could have been an even better round for them. But a win is a win. And it's going to be 12-8.
Yeah. And they've won so many rounds in a row. Nearly without any dents at all. So their money situation is out of this world right now. After buy, we see people with 7.3, 7.2. Everyone's at over 5k after buying up, so that's a great position to be in if you're LDLC, especially when you're getting on a roll like this.
And NaVi going for the A push again, which, I mean, earlier in this game when they were playing Hellraiser, in a different match, of course, that was, they were doing really well with this A push. I don't really blame them for going back to it. We'll see if it's going to work out. LDLC had the answer last time. This time, they have a different setup, and that can actually cause a lot of trouble for them. Happy wants to boost off on the box here, see if he can catch anyone. He does spot Edward, but this smoke is really making it difficult. Bomb is going to go down. He is seized, not getting tagged through, and now it's a 5-on-5 retake.
And this is going to fall apart. It's a quick one for one here already, the trade. But Apex has got a molly. He's going to chuck that at the back of sight. Seize is going to have to move or he's going to burn to death. And Seize stands his ground and takes one with him before going.
It's a pretty brave move. Flash goes out. Starix hiding in the corner here. He's got to be careful. Maniac's very close to him. And Starix still gets the kill. And now the bomb is too far. Tick here. Maniac, or Happy, sorry, should not be able to do this. And he won't. Edward will pick up the kill. Really nice round from Starix. I think if he had missed that shot, that could have actually been a big issue. But now it's 13-8. And Vendetta, LDLC, they're going to have to spend some of that bank now.
Yeah. And they're actually opting for two ops. So, quite the investment being made from LDLC right now. I'm curious to see where they're going to put Happy. It looks like they're going to put him in the A-bomb site, which I guess is fair enough. Kaylee's still in mid with AWP as well.
And interestingly, the one guy who doesn't have an AWP is actually Guardian, and he's waiting up here. And LDLC are actually pushing aggressively. If they just wait, Seized, if he has the right timing, he's going to be walking right into two people, and he goes down immediately, so... A lot of information and a really good kill coming in from LDLC early on in this round.
Yeah, even better, they back off. So they give no answer there for Na'Vi, no potential answer. Kaylee will manage to pick up another frag, and there's Happy using the AWP at A pit. So that just tumbled all apart there for Na'Vi. They lose Seized early on in B apartments due to LDLC pushing. I mean, the round before this, was it the round before this where they pushed two guys into A apartments? Either way, round before this, the round before last, still, I love LDLC's aggression all across the map, really getting up in Na'Vi's face and not letting him set up anything early on.
I do have a bit of a question, though, because it seems to me like a really weird thing that Guardian is obviously set up waiting and anticipating an aggressive push, and then Seized shows up and says, no, let's just forget about that and just, like, you know, just rush in. It seemed like, you know... I don't know, it just seemed like they had a different mentality going into it, obviously, but I don't know, that was a bit unfortunate, because if they had been able to wait long enough, that would have been even better. But you're right, I'm still a big fan of, I think, generally speaking, CT aggression on this map can be so valuable.
Especially when you're playing a team like Na'Vi, who are notoriously slow to get into position.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you're right. That's the big thing to take away from this. And Maniac gets a nice double spray down in B apartment. So, and he actually lives through that without taking a single point of damage. So
really
insult
great.
To injury there for Maniac. But you're right, Ben. I mean, that's the thing. It's against teams like Na'Vi, against Titan, if you can get up in their face early before they can throw out the smokes, before they can find the picks, that's really big. And it's why I've always enjoyed watching, you know, LGB, though they aren't together anymore. They used to play this sort of style, just... Double push into A apps, double push into B apps, always pushing on the CT side to just get that early edge. LDLC showing that they're capable of it. With players like Apex and Kaylee, it's good to see them playing to their style.
So right now, Na'Vi have had a couple of chances or to have rifle rounds, and none of them have featured an AWP on Guardian. I actually think this is now starting to be a problem. They're going to buy up once again, but I really want to see Na'Vi invest in that rifle. I think they're making... a mistake in not investing into it, basically.
It's hard to argue against that when they let him have the AWP on... in the game versus Hellraiser, just he nearly dropped 40 frags, so...
Happy waiting on the other side here, throws out a grenade, Edward almost catching him and he's gonna make his escape. Edward wants to get this kill and he is finally gonna be able to connect. Still pretty good movement from Happy and Kaylee. Will easily take down Edward, so a bit of a mistake here from Na'Vi. I mean, when they have the advantage, they need to hold on to a little bit longer than just 2 seconds.
Oh, and there you go, flash over, stealing that play from Titan, but I like it, just the same. And Na'Vi are just losing players left and right. I mean, LDLC are all across this map. They're peeking at mid, they're peeking A apps, they're peeking A pit, like they just... Na'Vi can't feel safe anymore. They can't feel safe anywhere on this map to be able to set up for anything at all without getting an entry first. That's pretty much it. LDLC have taught them that, hey, if you take your time, we're going to get up in your face and you're not going to be able to set anything up.
I mean, at this point, I'm heavily favoring LDLC to actually make the full comeback and win this from a 12-3 deficit. And as great as it is to see LDLC really, really mentally getting back into the game right away, I also have to say, I think Na'Vi's just making some really silly choices at this point in the game. And they're being punished for it hard.
Alright, well, they're flanking the door like bouncers over in the apartments, and Maniac's gonna get the first kill, but they should be able to rush him down. Apex, Zeus, Kaylee, they're all lending a hand, and it's not happening. The apartments, Navi, they had a golden opportunity, and the only kill they should get is Maniac, and that's gonna be the case. Maniac gets caught, but only after getting two of his own. LDLC with a near-perfect hold.
If they don't get the orb, and there it is on Guardian, so I think it could actually be too late for them to do this. I mean, he doesn't have armor, but I don't really care. I just think that's what they needed to do basically five rounds ago. And I think they may have played themselves in by waiting so long, actually. But we're glad to see LDLC have so much money that basically for Na'Vi to win, they just need to win three rounds here. They're not going to force an eco, I think. Kaylee jumping down into the pit and... into underpass. He's going to pick up a great kill in this. Happy with another one. And it all incredibly early on the round here. It just falls apart for Na'Vi. Just, I don't know, this is just very disappointing, I feel like, for the terrorist side.
I'm gonna actually go the other way around and say I'm really impressed by LDLC, because they obviously get that Na'Vi are having a really hard time actually adapting to the fact that they're not allowed to just set up as they prefer. And they're able to punish Na'Vi for it each and every time, and I think that's why Na'Vi actually bought up with AKs for so long instead of going with the op for Guardian. Simply because that gives you more mobility, you might be ready for those early aggressive push coming out from LC. They didn't manage to get anything out from it, and even when Guardian picks up an AWP, LDLC are still able to catch them off by surprise.
Oh, I'm definitely impressed by LDLC too, but there is, to me, there's an element of Na'Vi just basically like waiting way too long before they started realizing, oh wait, we no longer have that 12-3 lead. We should probably, you know, get back to something that's a little bit different as well. So I don't know. That seemed to me like I think maybe that early lead has led to them being a little bit too content with the situation.
Right. Well, the one round they have gotten was that set A strat, and they've tried that twice, I want to say, that exact same strat. And it has a 50% win rate, I guess, at this point. So seeing how that's the only place where you've gotten a round, why not try to go back to that?
Yeah, but I think LDLC have a really good shot at defending this one. I love this setup from the Frenchman here. Apex and Uzi down in the shadows just waiting. And then probably Happy should get smoked off here. But now he's moving into an even better position. So I'm just a big fan of this. LDLC, see if they can make this full comeback. It's definitely been a great run from them so far. And maybe they can do it. Uzi with a great pickoff. Seized is going to go down. And Uzi almost a triple. And now it's a 3-on-3. But this grenade could do great damage. Starix survives it for just another second, and Maniac's now coming in. Still no bomb plant, and LDLC, they have a really good chance of doing this. Guardian up close, and it's going to go down to Maniac, and next in line is Seuss, leaving Starix alone, and there's no chance for him to do this any longer. So, nice effort, but I think the setup from LDLC has been too strong.
I think they actually got into the bomb site pretty okay. It's just how they played out from it, because, they still haven't gotten the bomb plant down. And obviously that's a bit of an issue. Going 2-for-2 at the beginning there as they go into the site, I think that's fine. But they need to have something they can do to push their advantage further and actually get the bomb down and have LDLC chasing for something.
Yeah, and not just in this match, but I feel like actually today when we've been seeing Mirage in general, I feel like we've been having a lot of matches where it's been very, very tough for the terrorist team. Well, not to take the bomb site, but to actually put the bomb down once they have it. Even with the smokes and everything, it seems like a lot of teams are... they're spending a lot of time. It's not, you know, quick in and put the bomb down and then defend it. It's more like quick in and then wait for a long time and hope you don't get killed and picked off. And then eventually maybe you can put the bomb down and then everyone's already shown up. So it feels like maybe there's something going wrong for some of these teams in that sense.
That's valid. That's valid. I'm having flashbacks to Aces ROG, where Mirage was so CT-sided. And we saw that throughout the entire group stage, and it just was a CT-sided map. And right now, it's looking very solid for LDLC. Just calm, patient, getting in there with the aggression, but then not giving away the advantage. So this is really good right now. Na'Vi are still trying to find a way onto this A site, it seems. They've managed to sneak a man up Edward into Connector with support from Starks from A pit, but they need to go. They need to really just go at this point and try and overwhelm the defense. But there's a double setup in Shadow right now for LDLC. They're really committing to the A play, to just dodging the smokes.
Oh, great shot on Maniac there. Edward's going to go down in spite of that really cool position early on. Now it's going to be down into a 2-on-3. Kaylee missing an important shot here. And Starix is going to try and see if he can smoke him off. And that just might work. But Kaylee's going hyper-aggressive on this one. I'm loving it. There's only 20 seconds left. If the bomb dies in window right now, that's going to be massive. Kaylee picks up one kill. Seuss has to stay alive. He's in a 1-on-1. And he's just going to be able to put the bomb down here. But Happy, I mean, he's been clutching it all day long. So let's see if he can do it once again. Double for both players, and he just runs in and spams, takes Seuss down to 32 HP. And this one-on-one could definitely go Happy's way. The C-set 75 is more than enough. He's going to try with the AWP, doesn't get the shot through. Seuss is going to be the one peeking. He's really nervous. You can tell here that Navi's player is not feeling comfortable. He's going to go for it, sprays down, and Happy will pick up the kill. And he's even going to go and give him a little kiss on the cheek at the end there. 15-13, and no luck at all for Navi.
No, the HP call at the end there. Three guys instantly respond. 28. And that's just like taking the dagger that's already been stuck in Seuss and giving it a good firm twist. Yeah, like, yeah, you were that close. You were that close to clutching the round. So, Navi, they still have enough money to go for a buy because of that plant. But LDLC are now one round away. And they're just looking so determined to take this map. One of the sickest comebacks we've had all night long. If not the, I think it's pretty much the sickest comeback. I think it's the only comeback that we've had today. So
definitely,
LDLC are determined to end this night in style with the last match.
Yeah, 12-3 first half. And now we're looking at a 15-13 match and map point here for LDLC. And now we decide, let's just rush this A bomb site and get it done with. I think they're a little bit tired of what's going on here. Uzi with the kill. Guardian will pick off Uzi in return. So now it is a 4-on-3 as Kaylee picks up a really quick double kill. It's going to be just two members alive. Edward coming up from connector is a good idea, but Kaylee is just eviscerating the Navi lineup. That's four kills in quick succession, and LDLC win it 16-13. So what a game, and what a disappointing result for Navi, all things considering. But guys, that's going to be the last of the evening that we have. Nothing more here, but it's been a really long day already. I'm so glad you guys wanted to tune in. Now, you have a couple of ways you can help us out here with the channel if you want to. You can obviously follow it. We really appreciate it. Subscribe as well if you want to. Or just put it on low quality and stick around and watch a few ads. Maybe just mute the channel if you want to. We really do appreciate it. But that's going to be it. Have a great evening, and I will catch you guys soon enough. Semron Vedetta, of course, thanks for another great evening. And I mean, I guess I'll talk to you guys later.
Sounds like a plan. Good night, everybody.
Good night, everyone. That is going to be it. Have a great time. Go and play some Counter-Strike if you feel like it, and I'll catch you back on the channel soon enough.